be thinking, shouldn't we be designing and building age-friendly cities and not just these isolated, specialized facilities for older adults? Well, in answer to that, the World Health Organization has developed an age-friendly city and environments program. It is aimed at positively affecting the health and well-being of older adults by ensuring that the physical and social aspects of their living environments support their needs. 8 dimensions of the living environment are targeted: the built environment, transport, housing, social participation, respect and social inclusion, civic participation and employment, communication, and community support and health services. To foster and share information gained by participation in the program, the World Health Organization Global Network of Age-Friendly Cities and Communities was established. Communities in the program range from very large cities to relatively smaller cities. This guide is informative for anyone wanting specific knowledge about avenues of potential improvement to the living spaces older adults inhabit. Well-designed environments can also promote healthy activities. For example, well-laid-out walking paths with level surfaces, as well as access to wellness facilities like pools and exercise rooms, and so on, are associated with increased physical activity among residents. There is evidence that providing covered pathways and courtyard gardens increases outdoor activity. Wheelchair height gardening beds provide an activity as well as great produce. One study even found that people in a nursing home walked further and faster when they listened to music while walking. The Society for the Advancement of Gerontological Environments has promoted the creation of positive and therapeutic environments for older adults, particularly in the nursing home setting. This organization espouses a set of design principles that reflects a person-centered care philosophy. These include expected aspects of design, like physical safety, but also include designing for psychological security and well-being. This includes environments that are home-like, comforting, which are not confusing and disorienting. It includes both the inside as well as outside features of a facility, such as gardens.